Hey guys, JKMan99 here, and welcome to my preview and review, or recap or reaction, whatever you want to call it, to the final episode of How to Get Away with Murder. Stay, that's the name of the episode. So, we are down to basically two mysteries left. That's what they gave us, and I think I have a final prediction. And like all my predictions, it's going to be wrong, but I'm going to say what it is, and then I'm going to let you watch me react to whatever they decide to do. So, prediction number one, of course, they have not addressed Wes yet. And in the last episode, I was waiting for him to show up as a surprise witness. It did not happen. So, to me, that tells me that Wes is dead. That tells me that he's not actually alive. And he's either in a dream of some kind or the afterlife. And I'm leaning towards afterlife. They could do a quick dream thing where he goes on stage, says something, Annalise wakes up, oh my God. And like and I believe that there was even a clip of her like opening her eyes in the casket. So, I mean, I think there's a few things going on there. But I'm really leaning towards afterlife because they have been... They've said all season long Annalise is going to die. Like, they've been preparing us for this. So I think it's going to happen. Like, I know earlier, like, when she went on the run, that made me think, oh, fake death, haha. But I think that was a smokescreen. I think she will die. This is what I think she's actually going to do. I think that... Now, in the last episode, Frank now knows who his parents are. Which I think is making us want to think, oh, Frank does something nuts here. I don't think that's what's going to happen. I don't think it's going to be Frank in the end. I think they've covered that. I don't know what he's going to do in this episode. He might just be like, oh, I'm fine. I think we're finally going to have our Gabriel moment. Because what the heck? What is he... If he doesn't do anything, if Gabriel doesn't do something in this episode, because he's still around. He was at the trial. Like, I thought he moved. I thought they were actually done with him until I saw him at the trial. So what I think is going to happen... is, first of all, I think Nate, that's the other thing, I think Nate's still going to be a good guy. I think Nate's going to come in at the end, and he's going to stand up for Annalise, and he's still trying to get the governor, but he's not going to turn on Annalise completely. He's going to get up on the stand and basically be like, I don't know nothing. Something like that. Then I believe that through that testimony, Annalise will be found not guilty. And when Annalise leaves the courthouse, because they showed that courthouse thing for a brief second, that's when... there will be a shooting, and the kids will be shot at because of Gabriel. And Annalise will step in front of the shot, and that's how she dies, as her final act of still protecting the kids. It's poetic. It makes a lot of sense. I think Frank and Bonnie run off. They somehow get away with it. I think Nate somehow gets away with it. I mean, that's the title of the show, so it kind of makes sense. The only thing I have no idea what's going to happen is Conner. I feel like Conner is somehow going to get out of not going to jail. I don't know how, though, yet. So, we will see what happens. I will show you my reactions to the major things. And then I may or may not have a final word at the end. We'll find out. Hope you enjoy the video. Yes, one more rewind.
You hung up on your dad, right? That's what all this is about. Would you be? He killed that girl alive. Don't forget that. I believe he did that. He did. You know how I know? Because he had me do it. Didn't know she was pregnant at the time. Sad, right? Your dad had me kill your sibling. Take the money. Get away from all this. Or Sam's gonna destroy your life like he's done everyone else.
Okay, that was intense.
From her hard drive.
No, you don't have to tell that lie.
No, I will say whatever it takes.
I want a divorce.
I'll leave.
What?
I refuse the deal. I go to prison as soon as the trial's over. And I'm not going to ruin your life that entire time.
I know better. You're going to be happy. I know better. Okay?
Thank you. Now I know how to love.
Not end well for these guys. Who are you calling? Laurel? Okay.
The number you are calling has been disconnected. Please check the number.
Really? Wow. That's how they go.
Somewhere new, meet new people.
Mommy promises no more
bullying,
okay? We have to be safe, happy.
Oh my God! Why is he getting killed? Really? Okay.
Hey, precioso.
Oh my God! Well, Frank goes down.
Eve?
That is the afterlife.
Frank, I'm here.
Guys, make it right.
No.
Tell him, Annalise.
No, you can tell her. You can tell her. No, you can tell her. Why?
No, come on!
No, buddy, no. Stay with me.
That's not to say Annalise was easy to love. But then when you thought of that young girl from Memphis, I think that's what she valued most about her life, not the trial she won or glass ceiling she broke.
Everyone take your seats. It's our first day of law school, which means we're already behind. I'm Professor Christopher Castillo. This is Criminal Law 100, or as my mentor liked to call it.
Oh!
How to get away with murder.
Holy crap! Oh man!
Live from his house with Stephen Curry later tonight.
Sunday, I don't
know. Oh wow!
America, are you?
So yep, I was wrong about it all, and I knew I was going to be because I said that. But what I didn't expect was to be right. And what I mean by that is, I was 100% convinced there that I called the afterlife thing. I was just like, there you go. It makes total sense. You're seeing the rest of them old. The only time it didn't make any sense was when he was like, well, who are they? I really thought it was afterlife. I was so sure. And then I'm like, well, why are they showing Middleton? And then obviously Christoph Christie. Okay. Makes total sense. And that also explains why, like, Frank and Bonnie weren't there. I mean, like, so let's just back up to that. I did not see Frank and Bonnie dying. I didn't see Bonnie dying, like, because she sits there so long, like, Frank, no. And then all of a sudden she realized she's shot. Like, I guess the adrenaline was just running or whatever. That surprised me. And plus they said who killed Annalise, and, well, that implied she died. And yes, she died of natural causes after living a long life. I think I did have that as a theory at one point, that she died of herself or whatever, but, like, I don't know. And obviously the answer to why Wes was there, it was never Wes. It was his kid the whole time, and the funeral scene was real. It was not the afterlife. And it was them aged coming to Annalise's funeral, and Christoph was there. And turns out that Conner and Oliver get together at some point, and Michaela just is not there. And Gabriel, nothing. Waste of time. I'm sorry. I mean, I guess if you wanted to have your red herring there the whole time and that's what you wanted, congratulations, show. You pulled it off. But, oh, man, like, you wasted your time with that. And I guess he took his money, he didn't testify in your hand, but, like, why would you even do that? Like, you're lying, and I guess I'm fine with it now. That's rough. I mean, unless he basically stopped caring because of what Frank said. Frank was just like, you know what? He told Gabriel that Sam ordered him to do a murder, and then it's like, oh, I guess Sam really was a bad guy, so I'm just going to take the money and run. I guess. I'm not thrilled about that. Now, they did a really good job. She made a really good speech, and she got to live this great life. But, like, and she accepted who she was for herself. That was neat and everything. The only thing I don't like about that is I never liked the Annalise character. Viola Davis is wonderful, but the Annalise character, I've never been a fan of. I never have. And I know she's the star of the show, but, like, like, she gets the happy ending, and Michaela doesn't. They really treated Michaela bad in this one. Then Conner. There's so much. I'm glad Conner and Oliver ended up together. Feel bad that Michaela, God knows what ended up happening with her. I guess she seemed fine in the end. And then Laurel went off with Christoph. And Laurel's father got killed for no good reason, like, in the episode. Like, that just was like, oh, and he died. All right. And Annalise, or Anime, whichever you want to call it, ends up with Tegan for a while, and then, I guess, like, six other lovers. I'm not sure how else they could have ended it, except for the scenario I came up with where she sacrifices herself for the kids. I thought that would have been poetic, too. And, yeah, and I'm mad at myself that I didn't realize that Wes was not speaking English. I should have figured that. That should have jumped out at me immediately, and it did not. Good show. I'm gonna miss it. I'm trying to think if there's anything that they did that. Okay, one other thing, because Nate started going really dark there at the end, but he opened up a Justice Center. Okay, sure, great. And then obviously Frank's killed people, Bonnie's killed people. No one really ever found out about Bonnie killing Rebecca. And they both die in the end. So it's kind of poetic justice there. So not perfect. And I feel like everybody has a soft spot for Nate, and nobody wanted to see anything bad happen to Nate. And I guess he redeemed himself at the end by not lying about Annalise, essentially. Ha! So that's all I got. This will obviously be my last reaction video to this show. So I hope you guys enjoyed these videos I've made over the past few years. I hope everybody takes care. So thank you very much for watching. Take care.